Hi, it's Wilma. Welcome to my video. Today I wanted to show y'all some of the art that I made in October. And if you're not familiar, in October I was doing a magtober, which is a prompt list made by Max Moreau, and you basically try to make art every single day or for as many days as you can in October. And I wanted to make a video about it to show some of the art that I made and also talk about some of the stuff that I learned. So I was doing magtober back in 2020 for the first time. That's the only other time that I've done any sort of monthly challenge like this, and back then I completed all the days. This time I only did 24 of the days. Well, not only, like, that's still a lot of art, but yeah, I just wanted to talk about some of the stuff that I learned and show some of the art. I'm not gonna be showing all of it, obviously, because that would be a very long video, but if you do want to see all the art that I made, it's on my Instagram, so you can go check that out. And yeah, that's pretty much all that I wanted to say. I hope that you'll enjoy my video, and we're gonna get into it. Okay, so before I get into talking about the stuff that I'm gonna talk about, I just wanna say that I'm not gonna be talking about every single art piece separately. I do wanna say that this first art piece I didn't film the whole process for, so I kind of stopped filming at the ugly stage, but I will include the final product, but I just wanted to include this because it was the first prompt. The first thing that I wanted to talk about is the goals that I had before starting this challenge. So I didn't really have that many goals, to be honest. The first one was that I wanted to try to complete every prompt, but also know that it's okay if I don't do every day, and to remember that I don't have to be so hard on myself, because last time I did this, I literally wouldn't leave my studio until I had something good that I felt like I could post. And this time I was like, okay, well, I don't want to put that much pressure on myself, because besides for this whole monthly challenge, I also had a lot of stuff going on in my personal life. So I was like, I know that I'm not gonna be able to complete every day. So I was like, my only goal is that I'm gonna try to do the days that I feel capable of, and if I don't do every day, then that's okay. And the only other goal that I had was to try to use a lot of different techniques, which is something that I already do in my art. I know there's artists who only stick to using maybe one or two techniques or mediums, and for me, I basically like to use any sort of medium I can get my hands on. So for this challenge, I think I used all the techniques that I have, or all the mediums that I have, except for acrylic paint. I used aquarelle paint, ballpoint pen, graphite pencils, colored pencils, squash paint. I think that's it. But yeah, I just wanted to use a lot of different techniques because I felt like this was a really good moment for me to improve with a lot of different techniques and to have fun. And yeah, so those were pretty much the only goals that I had. As I said, I didn't really want to put too much pressure on myself, so I tried to keep it very simple.
Night breezes seem to whisper, I love you.
Okay, so one of the first things that I've learned from this challenge, which is something that I became aware of last time I did this as well, was that I don't have to create something perfect every single time, and it's actually a lot easier than I thought to create art that I like when I accept the fact that it doesn't have to be 100% perfect. Something that I struggle with a lot when I make art is that I'm such a perfectionist, and I think being a perfectionist can be definitely both a blessing and a curse, but it does remove some of the fun from making art because you become so focused on creating this perfect masterpiece that you forget to actually enjoy the process of art. So making art every single day and knowing that I had a fresh start every single day was very helpful. And I think it's pretty important when you do make art. I think there needs to be some sort of balance, obviously, with having some sort of perfectionism and kind of letting go of that, because it does help you move forward and improve, but it also can hold you back if it becomes too much. So I think you kind of have to have a balance with that. But this challenge definitely taught me that it's important to let go of that and to just not always strive for perfection. And I think it's definitely easier said than done. But at the beginning of the challenge, I kind of felt like I wasn't really there mentally, like I was really trying hard to make the prompts look good. And then I think towards the end, I kind of let go of that and I was like, okay, I'm just gonna make whatever I do and and then we'll see how it turns out, and if it's not good, I don't care. That like changed everything. I think whenever I started thinking that way, my art just became a lot better and I had a lot more fun. And yeah, so that was a huge and very important thing that I learned throughout this challenge.
Gotta keep dreaming.
Leave the worries behind you. But in your dreams, whatever they be, you've gotta make me a promise.
Something else that I learned is that sometimes letting go is better than pushing forward with something that's giving you trouble or not working out the way that you wanted it to. And I think this can be hard if you do want to complete every single prompt and every single day, because if you go into it and you're like, okay, I'm gonna try to do as many prompts as I can, and if I can't do all of them, that's not a big deal, then this is very good. But if you want to complete every single prompt, obviously it's gonna be hard to let go. But I think art can really take a toll on you mentally if you push yourself too hard, and anyone that's ever created art is probably aware of this. And I really had to learn how to let go, and there were a few times where I was really trying to make art and it wasn't working, and I was like, I'm not gonna try to do anything else, I'm just gonna basically give up and let go, and I literally could just like make art again tomorrow, like it's not that big of a deal. But I think I used to think it was such a big deal because I just put so much pressure on myself. So the fact that I had the goal going into it to be like, I want to try to complete all of them, but if I don't, then that's okay, I think that really helped me, and it really made me create a lot of art that I enjoyed. And I think that's just like one of the most important things when you do make art, that you actually enjoy it. So I'm very happy that I was able to have that mindset. La-di-da-di-da-di-dum, 'tis autumn. Then the birds got together to chirp about the weather. After making their decision in birdie-like precision, turned about and made a beeline to the south. My holding you close really is... Hi, I haven't really filmed any clips of me in the whole process of this challenge. I'm currently on day 20 and I was like, I probably should film some clip of me talking. But yeah, I'm more than halfway through October right now. I would say it's been going really well, honestly. I have made art almost for every day, and I'm proud of myself. I just finished with today's prompt, which is boba tea. I think this turned out very cute. And yeah, it's been really nice to like really focus on not being so detailed and being a perfectionist, because that was like a big problem, I guess you could say, I had. Well, I don't really think it's a problem. It doesn't have to be a negative thing, but I do think there's art in being able to be loose, and not that I'm super loose with my art, but there's definitely art in being able to not put so much pressure on yourself and not be a perfectionist. So it's been super nice to have this challenge to focus on that and to just like do whatever I want. And yeah, I would say it's going pretty well. I am pretty stressed out right now, and it has nothing to do with the whole magtober challenge. I just like, I have so many things going on in my personal life, and it's taking a toll on my body and brain. But I try to be as good to myself as I can and like treat myself with kindness and all that. So yeah, but it's going well, at least this challenge is. And yeah, that's about it. That's all of the update I had. It's not gonna get more interesting than this. So let's continue with the next art piece. Okay, bye. All right, So the next thing that I want to talk about is motivation. Now, before you start a challenge like this, you might think to yourself, how am I supposed to be motivated to make art for so many days? And basically, when you do something like this, at least for me, I'm sure a lot of people can probably relate as well, you realize that motivation is something that you create and not something that just like magically appears. Obviously, it can just like come to you, but I think for the most part, motivation is something that you have to create for yourself, and it isn't just gonna magically appear. I know this, and I think if you do make art consistently, you are probably aware of the fact that a lot of the time you kind of just have to get yourself to make art, and then the motivation eventually comes to you. But yeah, motivation is something that you have to create, and you basically just have to show up every day and do your best, and you can't really do more than that, you know? And with a lot of the art that I made, I didn't feel super excited to make art before I did it. For most of them, I probably felt that way. But then when I'm actually in the process of making art, that's usually when I do gain motivation. So you kind of just have to get yourself to do it. And then once you're in it, it is so much easier. You really realize when you're making art every day that you are capable of so much more than you think you are. There were so many days, like for example, when I did the prompt side profile, which by the way is like one of my, probably maybe my favorite art piece that I made from the whole challenge. But when I did that one, I think I was on my first day of my period, which is usually really bad for me. I have like a lot of cramps and stuff, and I had literally been in bed all day, and I was like, I can't miss these prompts, like I have to go and make art. So I got to my studio and I made this, and I was like, oh my god, I really did that. And even when I was feeling so shitty, I was still able to create something beautiful, which is pretty cool and inspiring. Obviously, I'm not saying that you should push yourself if you're sick or if you're like really not feeling it. I think sometimes rest is obviously the better option, but I do think that when you do something like this, you realize that you are capable of so much more than you think you are. Next thing that I want to talk about is doing this challenge really made me find my love for art again. If you have watched any of the videos that I've made in the past like year or so, I've talked a little bit about self-doubt in art and struggling with confidence, and I'm not gonna get into it again because I don't want to repeat myself, but I was struggling with that. And basically when I was making art this consistently for a whole month, it helped me so much with finding that love for art again. Because I think that I was in like a very weird, I don't know, I think I've been in a weird stage with my art for a while. Like I feel like I say it so often, and then I'm like, oh, I'm out of it now. And then I'm like, oh, I don't feel great about my art. So, I mean, I guess that's maybe how it's gonna be forever. I don't know. But doing this challenge really made it obvious that art is something that I love to do, and it brings me a lot of joy. And it's also a very calming and therapeutic thing for me, which is kind of like why I started making art. So yeah, I am very thankful that I was able to find that love for art again. And as I was gonna say about confidence, I think that not only do you get confidence when you're like, oh, I didn't think I could make art today and now I just made this masterpiece, but also doing so much art in a month and doing so many pieces that you're like, oh, I actually like this. That gives you a lot of confidence, and that was a really great feeling to have, and I'm also very thankful for that. And if you are someone who has been thinking about doing some type of challenge like this or making more art than usual or something along those lines, I know that it can seem very intimidating and you might be thinking, how am I gonna be able to do this? But I think once you're actually in it, it's not as bad. And I think it's also important to treat yourself with kindness and realize that maybe not every day will be a good day for making art, but a lot of days when you don't think you can make art, you actually can, and that's gonna teach you so much and build a lot of confidence. So I would definitely recommend doing this challenge just because of those two things. Or, I mean, obviously there are so many good things about it, but yeah. Anyway, that's pretty much all that I wanted to talk about. I hope that I made sense. I never know if I make sense. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed watching all the art that I made in the video. As I said, all of it is on my Instagram. Well, not all of it, because I archived a few that I was like, these are ugly. But I do have a TikTok with all of them. So yeah, they're all on my Instagram if you want to go see. If not, then that's okay. And yeah, I hope that you all will have a great day. And hopefully I will talk to you soon. Bye.
Oh yeah, life is bad. Stormy weather, and I just can't get my poor self together.